It's been close to 2 weeks since dozens of residents were forced from their home after a water pipe burst in Springfield. Now they are looking for the community's support. Western Mass News reporter James Villalobos joins us in studio with the details. James?
Well, Sarah, many of those residents still have not been able to return to the place they call home, living in different hotels. And while they received some help from management, residents say it was not enough, considering the fact that they are still displaced.
This was the scene 2 weeks ago at the Bergen Circle Apartments in Springfield's McKnight neighborhood after a water pipe burst inside. Fast forward to Saturday, those hoses are now gone.
Seeing mold, pre-existing mold damage, so that was treated as far as on the management bill. So they are improving each apartment step by step. So that delayed the process a little bit.
Counselor Malo Brown tells Western Mass News that there was a number of pre-existing damages, such as mold, that has been getting treated.
They're aggressively looking to do around 25,000 worth of extermination, they said, as far as throughout the year. There'll be over 7 inspectors each floor going through the actual building, making sure that it's up to code.
Many residents have been moved around to hotels in South Hadley and West Springfield, but now almost all of them are staying at Tower Square in Springfield. While thankful for the help, resident James Mock says several residents are still struggling.
We know it's going to get fixed when we don't know, but until then, staying in a hotel in a box is not what we signed up for. We didn't cause the accident. We know it's just an accident, but at the same time, we want fair play.
Now the residents need help with one of life's basic necessities, food.
We had to throw all our food away because the power had to be turned off. We understand these, but what we don't understand is no compensation. We can't cook in the hotels. We can't bring certain foods in there. There's only a little microwave, and certain people are on restricted diets.
Mock says they received a $100 stipend from management, but considering the longevity of the issue, he says none of them expected to be displaced this long.
But unfortunately, the money is all done. So we have to still, while we're trying to figure out a way to actually come up with money to feed people, we still have to figure out how to feed people. So that's what we're dealing with.
We need your help. Thank you.
Now, as of right now, the hope is to have residents begin to move back in on Wednesday of this week, but that's only going to be those who didn't have their units severely damaged. However, it could take up to an additional week or two until many are able to return home. Counselor Brown, who you heard from in that story, is encouraging anyone interested or who is able to help to contact him personally. We have his contact info on our website, westernmassnews.com. James Villalobos, Western Mass News.